Madam Speaker, this House must put its foot down and demand Senator Keter, Senator Munyesh, to come here and explain themselves, even after this censure, in the shortest time possible. Failure to that, we will invoke the law. We will fine them. The relevant committee will fine him. And above the fine, we shall use the Director of Public Prosecutions to cause the arrest of the two ministers and the production of the same before this August House, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, allow me to say the causes of these fuel prices. Number one is overtaxation. There are 8 taxes on fuel, and all of them are very significant taxes. It's not just the VAT. There is VAT, there is excise duty, there is anti-adulteration of fuel levy, there is railway maintenance levy, there is all manner of taxes which have been imposed on fuel. 80 shillings out of 134, 80 to 81 shillings is going to taxes. We must bring this down. Secondly, certain policy interventions have caused this fuel hike, and it's important for the Energy Committee to conduct an inquiry to find out what policy interventions other than the tax are causing this fuel hike, because the Finance Act of 2018, Section 13, which is the contentious section, has been in place since 2013. So how come the recent hikes have come even many, many months and many years or several years after this Section 13 has been put in place? Thirdly, although I heard my senior again, Senator Wetangula, trying to deny that the issue of debt is responsible for this taxation, because for every 100 shillings, 68 to 70 shillings is going to pay debt. And today, I'm informed that the government now is trying to use the money borrowed from IMF to pay off the Chinese loans. That is how desperate the situation has got, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, I must say that I support the censure of CS Charles Keter of Energy. I support the censure of the CS for Mining and Petroleum, Senator John Munyesh. And I support that the duo be condemned to all the attendant consequences that go with the censure. And if they think they are joking, let them try to play hardball. Some of us have a little freedom and a little time to do some national duty. They must come here. It is not a request. It's no longer a request. It is mandatory. They appear here. And let them go easy on this house. I know the current crop of the executive have been taught and tutored on the language of arrogance and pride. But I want to warn them, they can take their pride and arrogance to the streets of Nairobi or Kisumu or Tharaka Nithi or Meru, but they cannot bring their pride and arrogance to this.